Life could be a dream. If I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and open, we'll meet again, boom. Ding dong, ding dong, lang, lang, lang.
Hey guys and gals, we're putting on the Ritz.
Which just means we've dressed up all fancy.
That's what they would have said 100 years ago, in the rip-roaring 1920s.
Hey, it's the 20s right now, the 2020s.
That's right, it's the 20s again. We're living in 2021.
I wonder what people back then would have imagined about life today.
That's right, they must have needed some real vision.
Like 2020 vision.
Okay kids, I want you to blink your eyes and look around.
What can you see around you?
If you can see clearly, they say you have 2020 vision.
God wants us to be able to see clearly, not just with our eyes, but with our hearts too.
That's what it means to have vision, to imagine the future.
Hi kids, today we'll be trying lollies that were invented 100 years ago. Isn't that amazing? We're trying to look for some heads. Do you know where some heads are? Let's go have a look. You see, over here is the heads.
Where? Yeah.
Eddie! I found a bunny lolly!
Now we're going to try the pears.
I can't believe they're from the 1920s.
How do they taste, guys?
This is my
very yummy.
Yeah.
Very yummy.
Very yummy.
Mm-hmm. I chose grape flavor.
I chose cherry.
I think this is my favorite. Blackberry and cherry.
Wow.
It tastes like, it's not sour, but it's like half sour.
How does that taste?
It tastes a little sour. It tastes like strawberry, but it's a little sour. It tastes a little sour.
This double bubble was made in 1928. Let's try it.
Yum.
That's yummy.
Even that soft. Even this soft. Drums up.
Very good.
It tastes like strawberry.
Now we'll be trying the spearmint leaves. These were made in 1920, just like everything else.
It tastes really minty.
It tastes really minty.
Is that good, boys?
Yeah. I love it.
I love it.
It's amazing how people could think up of these lollies over 100 years ago, and now we can enjoy them 100 years later. Imagine these lollies as a vision of God. We get to meet Him at the end of our life. Now that is something super sweet to hope for.
Just like these sweet lollies, having vision makes our life sweet because we have something to hope for.
Hello, I'm Oliver the optometrist, although most people call me Olly. I'm the guy that you go to help you keep seeing clearly. How amazing and incredible is the eye? You see, God designed the eye so intricately and so carefully. There's nothing quite like the eye in all the earth. In fact, perhaps some examples can show you just how amazing the eye is. Did you know that the eye has 2 million different working parts in it? It's quite like a wristwatch, isn't it? When you open up a watch and you can see all the cogs and everything inside, your eye is like that, except far more intricate. Did you know that the average human blinks 12 times per minute? I bet you blinked when I said that then. Also, the eye is able to distinguish 10 million different colors. Well, that's a lot more than just your regular blue, green, and yellow, isn't it, children? And did you know that it's impossible to sneeze with your eyes open? You might want to try that one at home. You see, God has given us the natural ability to see through our eyes, but He's also given us the ability to see with our hearts as well. What do you see for your family? What do you see for your future? What do you see for your friends? You see, when you put your trust in God, children, He will give you the ability to be able to see the future that He has planned for you. How amazing is that? Now, let's put your eyesight to the test. See if you can see Wally in this 1920s movie scene. He's wearing a red hat and glasses. 20 seconds left. Where is he? Ten seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. There he is, right over there. Marvelous job, children. We'll see you next time.
Hey guys, my name's Indy and I really love skateboarding. I started skating about 2 years ago and I realized it was so much fun. Since then, I've had an idea of building a skate ramp at my own house. How crazy is that? And we were able to make it a reality, which is so cool. So we're gonna show you our skate ramp. Come on, Aria. So I knew I wanted a skate ramp, but I didn't really know how to actually build the skate ramp. So what we did was we worked out how big each of the ramps needed to be. We worked out how wide they needed to be. And then my boyfriend, Sean, he's a builder. So he came in and helped us actually build the ramp, which is so cool.
Hi guys, my name's Aria and I'll be showing you how to drop in. The first thing you gotta do is place your board on the coping like this and put your foot on the very edge. One of the things that are really important to focus on when you're trying to drop in is one, to look where you're going, and second, you have to push down as hard as you can with this foot here, like this.
Oh, yeah.
One time when I didn't commit, I didn't push really hard on this foot here, and when I went down, I slipped out like that and I fell on my back.
Ouch, oh my gosh.
And it's just like in life too. If you see something you want, you gotta fix your eyes on it and you have to commit to it 100%. Just like following Jesus.
Sometimes though, when you try tricks, it takes ages to learn something you wanna get. Sometimes I'll spend hours and hours and days and days and days trying to learn something and I just can't get it. But it's in those situations where you know you just can't give up. You have to try and try and try again. And eventually, the thing is, you do end up getting it. So even though skating's hard, it shows you that if you put in the hard work, you'll get there. This is one of the tricks that I took ages to learn, but I'm really happy I've got it now. You ready?
This is the trick that I've been trying to get. I haven't got it yet, but I'm going to keep trying until I do.
Whoa, almost. Not only has skating been so much fun for me, but it's also given me opportunities to help other people that are learning. So when you work hard at the things you do, you can help other people who are learning too. And that's just one of the ways that God has used my skateboarding to help other people. So I encourage you guys, when you guys find something you enjoy doing, make sure you give all the glory to God and say, God, how can you use me in the things that I love? Because that's what God has done in my skateboarding and He can do it with you too.
Thanks for hanging with us, guys.
These lemons by themselves, only seeing them as they are, we can turn them into something sweet.
When life gives you lemons,
you make delicious lemonade.
Come with us.
Come with us.
Okay.
Put a vision inside of you? Yeah, you know, it's like a imagination or like a dream that you have about what the future could be like. Now God's put that inside of you because a vision is not just what you can see right here and right now, it's actually that picture of what your life could be like in the future. Pretty cool, hey? And because it's so cool, I think it's one of those things we probably want to make sure that we know what God's dreams are for us, so that we can cast our vision according to what God has in store for us, which is only good. Now, if you want to talk about vision, somebody we cannot overlook is Jesus. Jesus had epic vision. His vision was such that when he was walking around on the earth, he would often look around at people and he would see people who are broken and sad and you know, just hurting, and he would actually see them beyond that. He would see them as saved, restored, healed, you know, like, and those things actually happened. That's the amazing thing. And they happened because when Jesus was on earth, he absolutely believed every word that God the Father said to him. So he could see that already happening for people. His vision could go beyond their circumstances. Pretty neat, hey? Look, even when he was on the cross, when these people were hurting him, get this, here's a really cool thing. Jesus was looking straight down the corridor of time, which means he looked into the future and he looked right into us today and he saw us and he said, you know what? For that child and for that guy, for that girl, and they are worth me giving up my life. They are worth me getting hurt now so that they can be saved, they can be restored to God the Father, and they can have a relationship with God. How cool is that? Jesus saw you right where you are sitting right now, and he saw you many years ago and decided you are worth it. How amazing is that? Now, God's dreams for our lives is that we will have massive, ginormous, God-sized dreams for our lives. Because if we have that size dreams, we can have that size vision. And the important thing to remember about vision, like God says, is that you need the vision to have the hope. You know, so without vision, there's no hope. God wants you to have your vision casted further. Don't look at what's happening right here and right now. Look beyond this. And to do that, we need Jesus in our heart. So make sure that when you go through every day, you don't just look into what's happening now. You're actually looking at what God has in store for you, which means your vision needs to go beyond what's happening right now. Cool, hey? Look, let's pray together, and I'm going to pray for you guys. Now, if you never asked Jesus to come into your heart, now's a really good time to ask him to come into your heart and actually help you with that vision. And if you've done this before, well done, just as good. It doesn't hurt to keep on asking God to always remind you what his dreams are for you and for me. So let's do that. Let's pray together. Dear Jesus, I thank you that you love us so, so, so much. I thank you, Lord, that you have amazing dreams for us, and that your dreams that you have for us helps us to have a great vision of what life could be like in future. Please come and remind us of that and stay with us and come into our hearts and help us always hold on to the dreams that you've put in our hearts, because they essentially are dreams that you have for us. In Jesus' name, amen. Good job, guys. I'm going to give you a high five. You did so well. Go out there, get that vision going. Are you ready? Here comes a high five. Whoop.
So what do you see for your life, kids?
Vision isn't just seeing in the faraway future.
But what can we have vision for the future, right now?
We'll talk more about this next week. Let's stand up for some amazing praise and worship.
Love you lots, kids.
Bye.
Courage of our Savior on the cross for the I'll sing upon a shore.